From a window across the street, Eben Lavi watched the couple and the two children leave their loft and climb into the back of a white limousine. It pulled away from the curb and started down the street. A moment later, a blue SUV fell in behind the limo three cars back and began to follow. Eben pulled his disposable cell phone out of his pocket and thumbed a number. "Ziv?" "Yes," Ziv answered from the SUV in his old gravelly voice. "When they get to the park, go over to San Rafael and install the device. When you've finished, come back to the city. I'll call you when I'm ready to be picked up." Eben flipped the cell phone closed and turned to the two women standing behind him. One was named Karma, the other, Devra. "Get everything cleaned up here, then go to the airport to catch your flight," Eben said. "I'm going over to the park. I'll see you in a few days." "This is crazy," Karma said. "I say we just take her now and be done with it." Eben pulled a lighter jacket over his crisp waiter uniform and straightened his tie in the mirror. "That's my decision to make," he said calmly. "And now is not the time." "I agree with Karma," Devra said. "It'll be easy to take her here in San Francisco. Then while they're traveling," "Not necessarily." Eben walked to the apartment door and opened it. He paused before stepping into the hallway. "Have a good flight," he said. "I'll call you." He closed the door and walked down the hall, wondering for the 100th time why his superiors had decided to saddle him with two out-of-control women and an old man who should have been put out to pasture years ago. Wedding vows. "If the ceremony didn't end soon enough, I thought I might pass out, or worse. Will you, Blaze Munroz, take this man, Roger Tucker, to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold through sickness and health until death do you part? I will. Will you, Roger Tucker, take this woman?" I felt a drop of sweat dance down my side like a spider and disappear into the waistband of my itchy brand new suit pants, which I hoped never wear again. Mom, dressed in white wedding gown, stared through her veil at her husband-to-be, my stepfather-to-be, Roger Tucker, with loving expectation. In my entire life, I'd never seen this expression on my mom's face. At least, I don't remember seeing it. I glanced at my future stepsister, Angela Tucker. She was staring at her dad, who wore the same blissful expression as my mom. Angela looked like I felt. Through sickness, I didn't object to the marriage. In fact, I liked Roger a lot. It was just everything happened so quickly. And health, months ago passed. 3 months ago, Mom and I were living peacefully on our little sailboat in Santa Lucia, California, when Roger shows up at one of Mom's rare singing gigs with a pile of songs he wrote. Then, until death, they put together this band called Match and cut a single called Rekindled. The song goes platinum in 2 weeks. They're signed up for a record and to record an album. They get national tour, then do you. They announce their marriage, sell a sailboat, lease a bus, and sublet Roger and Angela's place in San Francisco. Part, here it comes. I thought, trying not to sway, Mom, Roger, Angela, and me. Quest, Muzo Q for short, are headed out on a year-long tour. As soon as Roger says, "I will," I now pronounce you husband and wife.